Hi everyone, in this little video I want to show how we set up the suction and the compression system in the machinery room in this case. So here we have we are underground, so the clinic is upstairs and here is the level lower. We install two compressor and two suction. So in this clinic we have 6 dental units and we wanted to separate the system, so to have 2 units that they work with one compressor and one suction, and the other 4 that work with one compressor and one suction. So why we didn't place one big compressor and one big suction is because in case we have a problem with one compressor, we can use the other one and keep going working. And the same for the suction system. Regarding the compressor, we have done 2 different lines, as I just explained. The compressor has a dryer system, so the air that arrives in the clinic is very dry and it doesn't create any problem. And we don't have to do much about the compressor. We just put the plug a bit up, not on the ground. So also the cable remain up from the floor. And we use copper pipes to do the internal system. One important thing, in the compressor system, we don't need to create 45 degrees angle, but we can use 90 degrees angle, that is not a problem. A thing that is different for the suction pipe that we are going to see now. So here we have the 2 suction motor. In this case are wet suction system. So we don't need any air separator mounted on the dental unit, air water separator. We are under the ground, so there is no problem for the suction pipe to arrive here. One important thing to consider is that we need to place the suction motor not over the pipe. So the motor has to be under all the pipe system in order to permit the suction to work. So in case we didn't have space on the same level of the dental unit, or we didn't have space on the basement and we have to place the suction motor one level over the clinic, so then we need to apply a dry suction system that permit to take only the air in the motor. But it's not the case. So here we have 2 wet suction system. If you can see here, there is the connection for the input that are connected to the unit. So these 2 cables allow the suction motor to turn on. Then we have the suction pipe that arrives to the motor, where you have the filter, and here you have the drain that goes to the vast water net. In this case, also this tube has to be over or at the same level of the motor. So that's why we applied these pallets or wooden upper level in order to avoid this problem, because we couldn't apply the tubes more down on the floor, because we have it's a bit higher. So also with the motor we have to be on the same level. One more important thing is regarding the air that come out from the suction. In this case we apply here because we didn't finish yet the work, and this pipe has to go outside because the air that arrives is dirty, and so we will make a hole in the window here and also the air go out. So all the bacteria that are arriving through the air has to go out, because if you pass through here it's full of virus or bacteria, especially now that there is also COVID and this kind of situation, is better to avoid to keep in the clinic. So basically you don't have to do any kind of maintenance here. if not to clean the filter that is inside here in this case. So you just turn and take out the filter and you wash. And remember that the compressor can generate water inside the chamber. And so we have the system to make empty the bottle that gather the water for the humidity that you can have around here. It's also very important to keep them in a very in a big area like here. So we have a room dedicated for the suction, and to don't close them in a cabin or something, because they need air to cool down, and they get very hot, so they need space and air circulation to work properly. I think that's all for this video, so thank you for watching and follow our indication to make a good job.